So now we are going to start with the next part, that is calorimeter. So calorimeter, it is a device which is used to measure the exchange of heat between two substances. And now we are going to draw the schematic diagram of that calorimeter. So this calorimeter is having the outer frame, which is known as the wooden jacket. The outer frame. Then there is this inner part. This inner part is actually the copper vessel. So this inner part, is this red one, is the copper vessel in which we have the various substances whose heat exchange is to be measured. Alright, these vessels from the inside as well as outside is polished in order to avoid the loss due to radiation. So we are having the losses in three types: conduction, convection and radiation. So by polishing its inside as well as outside, it means we have reduced the loss by radiation. Now, on the topmost, there is these wooden lids with two pores in it. These are the wooden lids with two pores in it so that the heat exchange by convention is to be prevented. These wooden lids helps in preventing the loss by convention. Now, this copper vessel and the wooden jacket is insulated by a material which is present in between these two things so that any loss due to conduction should be prevented. So, this is either wool, cotton or any other material as insulation. Alright. So this red one is the copper vessel. This is the copper vessel. The black one is the wooden jacket. The outer one is the wooden jacket. This blue one is either wool, cotton, any insulator. This upper one is the wooden lid. Alright. Through these two holes, one is the stirrer that we are adding it. Stirrer is added so that the temperature of the entire content will be equal, same. And this is the thermometer which is being injected through the other hole. And the main task is of the thermometer, which will be going to measure the content of, the temperature of the contents. Alright, so this is the thermometer. This is the stirrer. Now, the thing is why we are using copper vessel. Copper vessel is having very low value for specific heat capacity. So again, if a very low specific heat capacity, change in temperature will be very, very early. So it will not take time to change its temperature. So that is what we required. The faster the process is, the accurate reading would we get. Alright. So this is the calorimeter, and this thermometer will play a very, very vital role in telling us the temperatures before as well as after. Alright. So this is the calorimeter. Now, how this calorimeter is going to help, that we'll see in a moment. So, this is the schematic diagram of the calorimeter. Schematic diagram of calorimeter. It is made up of copper vessel, which is having low specific heat. Wooden lid prevents any loss due to convection. This wool prevents any loss due to conduction. And the polishing on inner and outer side will prevent any loss from the radiation. So, this is a calorimeter. Now, within this video only, let me discuss the law of calorimetry. Law of calorimetry, which is also known as law of mixture. Law of calorimetry is also known as law of mixture, and it states that heat gained by a body will be equal to heat lost by a body. Now, let us take a scenario. This calorimeter contains the cold water. This calorimeter contains the cold water first. Let it be like this. This calorimeter contains the cold water. So here is a cold water, which is, let us say, at 8 degrees Celsius or 10 degrees Celsius. The cold water will be at 10 degrees Celsius. So this 10 degrees Celsius is the reading given by the thermometer as first reading, because the thermometer was initially injected. So this is T1 as 10 degrees Celsius. Now, we have inserted a hot water stream into this. The hot water is being added. Now, when the hot water is being added, obviously the quantity will increase. The stirrer will perform its function to uniform the effect of both the temperature, that is 10 and this. Now, because the thermometer is not able to detect its initial temperature, because as soon as it enters, it mixes with water. So, we do not know the temperature of hot water. The temperature of hot water is unknown. But once the stirring is complete and the thermometer will stop rising or falling, then we'll say a constant temperature is acquired. That is the third temperature noted by the thermometer. So, T3 is, let us say, this hot water. We know that hot water that is coming from behind is of 80 degrees Celsius. That we know, but thermometer will not show any reading. It is 80 degrees Celsius. T3 is somewhat between this. Let it be 40 degrees Celsius. Now, we need to find out this temperature, question mark. We need to find out this temperature of hot water. Now, this calorimeter has given us this reading and this reading. Then, due to or by using this law of calorimetry that we'll be discussing in a minute, what is this law? We can find out that unknown temperature. Alright? Sometimes, in some cases, in numerical problems, they will give these two and we'll have to find out this, but again using the same formula. Heat gained by a body is heat lost by the body. Now, let us see what is happening inside it. There is the cold water. Then there will be this hot water. So there was this cold water and this hot water at their respective temperatures. This cold water is when mixed with hot water, the heat exchange will going to take place. This cold water will increase its temperature and the hot water will decrease its temperature. Why? Because there will be the transfer of heat energy from hot water to cold water. So, cold water will increase in its temperature, hot water will descend its temperature. At one time, they will be reaching to a constant temperature T3, which is 40 degrees Celsius. This temperature is the point where the thermal equilibrium is acquired, and that thermal equilibrium is the basis of this relation. That is, heat gained by one body is equal to heat lost by another body. But in order to make this particular, heat will be gained by always a cold body and heat loss will be always by a hot body. So, heat gained by a cold body is equal to heat lost by a hot body. Alright, and these two are equal because none of the heat is lost neither by conduction, convection or radiation. So, this is also based on law of conservation of energy. Alright. So, this is about the calorimeter. This is the schematic diagram. This is the law of calorimetry, that how much heat is, whatsoever the heat is gained by the cold body, it is equal to the heat given up by the hot body. Or we can say the hot body will lower only that much heat, the amount of heat which is being gained by the cold body. And these two will always be equal. That means heat gained by the cold body will always be equal to the heat lost by the hot body. Alright. So, this was the law of calorimetry and law of mixtures. From the next video, we'll start with some numerical parts.